Shalom Aleichem and welcome to Online Smicha. In the brachas of Sheva Brachas by Achasna during the week of Sheva Brachas, the bracha says, Baruch Ata Hashem Alekeinu Melech Ha'olam, Asher Yatzar Asa Adam B'Tzalmoy, blessed is Hashem who created man in his image, B'Tzelem Devot Tavnisoy, V'Hiskin Loi Mimenu Binyan Abe Ad. And Hashem prepared from him, from his own self, an everlasting edifice. Baruch Ata Hashem Yatzar Adam. It's a very powerful bracha. If you think about it, the concept of nisuin, the concept of marriage, the pasuk, the bracha we just said, is a binyan adei ad, an everlasting opportunity to have an everlasting effect. How does a human who is limited, a mugbal, where does he get this power to be able to affect adei ad? So perhaps we'll see what other structure or whatever thing in the world is adei ad, and we'll see how that works, and we'll see how perhaps we make a joint effort. We know that the Beis HaMikdash is referred to as Beis Olamim. Beis Olamim means we had the Beis HaMikdash HaRishon, we have the Beis HaMikdash HaSheni, and Beis HaMikdash HaShlishi will be forever and ever. How was the Beis HaMikdash built? Perhaps if we take some lessons from the Beis HaMikdash, from the Mishkan, from the Kedusha of the Beis HaMikdash and the Mishkan, you'll see how a person getting married, people getting married, has part of that. So the bracha applies that we should have binyan adi ad. When the Torah tells us the mitzvah of making a Beis HaMikdash, making a Mishkan, the Torah says, Va'asu li mikdash v'shachanti b'seichem. Make for me a dwelling place, a mikdash, and I will dwell amongst them. The Gemara says, just as by a Beis HaMikdash, the Gemara doesn't make this comparison as I said it, but just as by a Beis HaMikdash, the structure, v'shachanti b'soichem, the Gemara Masech Tesoita Daf Yudzayin Amar Aleph says, ish v'isha, when a husband and wife get married, zachu, if they merit, shechina shayra b'neihem, the shechina will dwell amongst them. God forbid, if loy zachu, if they don't merit, then God forbid they will be consumed in fire. Rashi explains that it's very, very clear in the names, in the word of Ish v'Isha, because Ish and Isha all have this, they share the same letters of Aleph and Shin. But by the Ish, there is a Yud in between, and by the Isha, there is a Hey at the end. The Yud in the Hey is if you allow Hashem to come in to your life, to the life of the Ish V'Isha, which is Ka, the name of Hashem, that's Zachu. That's when Shechina Shayra B'Nehem, God forbid. Loi Zachu, Hashem removes his name from husband and wife, and then Eish, all you left was Aleph and Shin. The Medrash in Vayikra Rabbah, Perek Lamed writes, by the base, the collections for the Beis HaMikdash, the collections for the Mishkan, it says v'yikhu li truma. Hashem says, take for me a truma, an offering, a donation. What does the Medrash explain? B'shvil sha'adur b'neihem. Do something that you will actually bring me amongst you. Ha'amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Hashem is basically saying, kichu oisi, please build something that you should take me and bring you into your life. V'adur b'neihem. And this is what it says, v'yikhu li truma, that Hashem begs each, the building of the Beis HaMikdash, and perhaps is the same by every chassan and kala, every husband and wife, please make sure that you bring Hashem into your life, and by bringing Hashem into your life, kisiv nebayis chadosh b'Yisrael, bring Hashem's name into your house, and then the house will be an everlasting edifice. It's interesting that it's mentioned in Svarim that Teruma, the gematria of the word Teruma is 651. Ish v'isha, it's 650. What does that mean? That as long as there's Ish v'isha, it's 650. If you bring Hashem into it and you do a Teruma, then it's 651. That is, you have to bring the one more, the Echad, Alufa Shalaylam, bring him into your life. From all the kalim in the Beis HaMikdash, all the kalim in the Mishkan, we obviously know that the Aron represents the most halakha keli. The Aron has a profound lesson for marriage. The Aron's lesson is, if you saw the shear that the Torah says how an Aron has to be built, amasayim v'chetzi. It's all in halves. Why? Because to have the Kedusha of Aron, to have the Kedusha that Hashem should be willing to dwell amongst the Mishkan, and dwell amongst a Jewish family, there has to be two halves. Everybody's it's important for every part to realize that he is only a half and be able to teruma, to give of yourself to the next. As it is by every chasim v'kala, in a miniature way, it is by every single yid. The pasuk says, v'shachanti b'soich b'nei Yisrael. Hashem says, I will dwell amongst every yid, b'nei Yisrael. Some mefarshim say, what does it mean, b'soich b'nei Yisrael, within b'nei Yisrael? So there is a beautiful remez. B'nei Yisrael. Take the b'soich of b'nei and the b'soich of Yisrael. The middle letter of b'nei is nun. The middle letter of Yisrael is resh. If you take those two letters together, ne'er, the Neir Hashem Nishmas Adam. The Neir Hashem Nishmas Adam is what you bring. You make the light of the Neshama flicker, burn loud and clear and shine. When you allow the Neir Hashem Nishmas Adam, then it's B'Soich B'nei Yisrael. The rest of the letters of those two words, B'nei Yisrael, is B'Yesh Kael. But you have to allow Hashem to shine in your life, and then you have the opportunity, the koyach of Hashem, to make a binyan ade ad, a everlasting, because only where you're tapping into the koyach of Ein Sof, the koyach of Hashem, him being one of your partners, with that you have the koyach to be blessed to make a binyan ade ad.